sitting with the amazing Tumi Sekhukhune alongside her here at the Taj Gateway Hotel. It is match day and I can sense a great air of anticipation. Tumi, lovely to chat to you and thank you for joining us on gsport.
No, thank you for having me.
I was looking at your profile and I remember one comment that you made. You thought you would only make your debut in 2020. We're sitting here in 2019, a year after debuting for South Africa. How does it feel?
Yes, I think I gave myself 2 years, 2 years, 3 years to make my debut because I was still also like still working my way up there, still trying to get better and better just to, and also like to better my performance. And little did I know, I just got a call up and then here I am.
So many people have got to go through a school system in order to be noticed and recognized. Tell us your journey and how you got found to be someone who is a potential for South Africa.
I think when I was young, I also didn't think that I would play for SA one day. I just loved playing with the boys and how their vibe is, you know, how they enjoy their cricket, how they laugh, the laughter and everything. And I think because of that, I fell in love with cricket. And my brothers also like used to encourage me to keep working. And also, I was a batsman. I was actually a bowling all-rounder. And then I think also again, like my other coach Raymond Rama, I feel from Davidson, he said to me one day, don't you want to play like professional cricket? And I was like, no, I just enjoy playing with the boys. And then he said to me, there's a place where you can go and do trials for a provincial team. And then I went to Eastlands and I got selected from there.
At the age of 14, here you are at Eastlands, and now you're at the age of 20 in Surat playing for South Africa. Do you pinch yourself and think, is this actually happening to me?
Yeah, no, I still can't believe it even now, but more than anything, I think it's an honor and a privilege to play for this badge, and I cannot trade it with anything.
When you look at black players in South Africa, everyone says, you know, the pressure is on you to be a role model. What is your one dream as a cricketer, and what would you like to do in terms of inspiring the youth?
I think I just want to show black people, and not just only black people, but the young girls that are coming up and that also looking up to people that are playing cricket, to know that it is possible, and they can even through the challenges and obstacles of having to find the perfect right bra size and having to go through the adolescent stages, that they can still do it, and it is possible for young girls to make a cricketer career.
You know that you are on your way to becoming a superstar. Do you sense it? Do you get a sense that there's a great journey ahead for you?
Yes, I believe and I know that I will be a superstar one day, because I know the drive and passion that I have for cricket and my hard work behind careers also will show that I will be a superstar one day.
Sharing the new ball with Shabnam Ismail here in India, it's a big opportunity, but also a little bit scary in front of this massive crowd. How are you coping with the pressure?
It is nerve-wracking, and I think, but more than anything, just looking at the crowd and thinking that, oh, these people are here to just watch cricket and the love they have for cricket. I think also again, I think take out like the best in me, and I just want to showcase what I can do in the field. And I know this one time Adane said to me, you actually bring out the vibe, you have the energy, and I think I'm and I'm also loving that I have the energy and I keep them going.
And you're in the field, you're such a live wire. If you're not taking a catch, you're getting a run out, you're doing something, you are that live wire. Where does the energy come from?
I don't know, I just love running, I just love showcasing my skill and my talent.
What is your message to young girls who want to follow in your footsteps? Because at the age of 20, you're already a role model to many.
I think what I'd say to them is that they must keep going and keep fighting, and also that love every obstacle and every challenge they go through, because it will be seen.
Yes. Someone's going to recognize it.
You know, someone's going to recognize it. And also, again, just fall in love with the process. Every obstacle, every challenge, just fall in love with it, because at the end of the day, it will
come true.
You know?
Because it is coming true for you. And if I look at the sponsors that you're picking up at the moment, because that tells you whether you're becoming a star or not. Tell us about some of the sponsors you've managed to pick up.
I remember this one time, I told myself that I wanted to be a brand ambassador for Adidas, and I just had that dream. But then one day, I got a message from Kobe Khan and said to me they want to give me a sponsor for my cricket shoes and my basketball shoes. And yeah, I just got the sponsor, and I think I'm so happy and excited to be their face, and also Black Widow as well, because it is very difficult for a person starting to get into cricket, because the facilities are very expensive, and you know, you can't afford them sometimes. And I think for me, it is a privilege to be their brand ambassador.
Well, this is a sponsor's dream that you're looking at. Tumi Sekhukhune, she's a future superstar. And if you look at someone like Makai and Tini, who really flew the flag for South African cricket, I think you're the next big thing.
Ah, thank you.